Hello, this is Alan Tharp with the National Pathfinder Youth Organization, back for another video. This video will be the second in the series on net making, and in this video we're going to cover the tools that you will need to start net making. First item you're going to need is a knife, of course. I'm not going to pull mine out here. You need a knife, that's common sense, or a pair of scissors, whatever you want to use. Next thing you're going to need is a shuttle or a netting needle. A shuttle is more for looming on a or weaving on a loom. First, I want to show you the commercial needles that you can buy. I know Dave did a video showing a commercial needle. You can get needles in lots of sizes, and this is only some of the sizes that I brought out. You have even smaller than these, and for doing lace work. Then you have a little bit bigger, you have short, a little bit longer. And they keep going up in size. I also have a hammock needle, which is like 13 inches long. It's for doing big nets. I didn't bring that out. But the reason I like these, they're very cheap. You can buy them individually. I think the common size one you would use would be this one or this one here. You can use the smaller, but you don't get as much cordage on it. So you have to, the bigger it is, or the longer it is, the more cordage you can get on it. The reason I like these is because these bend and they will not break. And they're very inexpensive. I believe you'll pay a couple bucks for one this size. And they're made of a good plastic that doesn't break when it gets cold. Now the next set of needles I'm going to show you are made of, are handmade. I made these needles here. The first ones that you can see here, these are made out of pine. This one is made out of a large paint stir from Home Depot. This is made out of a door shim or a window shim. You pick a pack of these up for like $5. There's like 15, 20 in them. Anything with these, they have a tendency to crack. You have to look for knots in these and the grain when you pick them out, and these are free, or at least the paint stirs are free. The small paint needles I wouldn't use because they do have a tendency to curve when you get a little bit of moisture on them, unless you seal them, but they will have a tendency to break easier because they're thinner. Next needle I have here is a set I have, and these are the two common sizes, 6-inch and 8-inch. They're made out of oak. This wood you can pick up at like Home Depot in the trim section. They're about 1/2 inch thick, 2 inches wide, and they come 3 to 4 foot long. Very easy to get lots of needles out of them. A little harder to carve because it is seasoned wood. So I didn't carve the, I used a bandsaw and sander and other things to make these, but that's another option. Another great wood would be poplar. You can buy the same pieces. I believe Brian Manning from Snowwalker 13 did a video making a netting needle using the same stock from Home Depot or Lowe's or whatever hardware store he has or lumber yard. Same thing. This wood's a little easier to carve. I like working with poplar. Very good wood, and this actually will flex some, so you don't have to worry about this breaking as easy as the oak. Now if you wanted to get us some really good hard wood, you can do something like lace wood. I picked this up at an exotic wood store we have up the road from the house. Very, very hard wood, will snap real easy if you step on it, but it's a very durable wood, very beautiful finish. Pretty much it for the needles. Now we're going to move into mesh gauges. Mesh gauges determine the size of the hole in your net, or the size of the mesh. I have a 2-inch here, 3/4, 1/2 inch, and 1/4 inch. And they range from size A, B, C, and D, and they can go up from there. One thing you have to remember about mesh gauges is if you're picking out a 2-inch mesh for your net, you actually have a 4-inch hole because it takes two passes to make a single mesh. And this only makes half a mesh. So keep that in mind. If you want a 2-inch mesh in your net, you need a 1-inch mesh gauge. And everything about these are nice. They're real flexible. The only thing I don't like about these is when you're holding it in your hand working, the corner will stab you and you will get cramps in your hand. That's why I recommend these here with a rounded edge. I do try to make them a little longer so you don't have to take your net off as much, but I round it off. It's easier to hold, more comfortable. Mesh gauges, you don't have to buy them. You can make them out of anything. This is made out of a plastic instruction sign off the back of a door. I'm not sure where it came from, but very good material. You can also make it out of exotic material. This is lace wood. Very good wood. Also have one made out of black heartwood from a palm tree. If you're going to use exotic woods, make sure you check what type of wood it is. This is a very fibrous, porous. This actually has holes that run through the grain. So it didn't work good for a needle, but it worked good for a mesh gauge. And this one you've seen before, this is my zebra wood mesh gauge. You've seen quite a few of my videos. Put markings on there for different videos making the width of your mesh. Now, one thing I wanted to tell you about mesh gauges and needles. Your needle has to be smaller than your mesh gauge. As you can see, you cannot use something like this with this because your needle will not fit through the hole. So always remember, your needle needs to be smaller than your mesh gauge. See, something like this here, I would have to use a needle like this. Now keep that in mind when you're making your needle or you're purchasing your needle and your mesh gauge. Make sure your mesh gauge is larger than your needle. Well, I think that about covers the tools that you'll need for net making, or at least to start out. When we start making nets, we'll get into vices, securing your nets. We'll get into the hardware like the split rings, the snap rings. We'll get into horns. We'll get into circular mounts. We'll get into all kinds of other hardware that you'll need depending on the kind of net you're making, whether you use rabbit rings or you use slider bars, T-bars, dog bones they call them. So we'll get into that later in later videos. Well, I hope this video was helpful. If you have any questions or comments, please feel free to ask or leave them down below or send me a personal message or email if you have it. Once again, it's been Alan Tharp with the National Pathfinder Youth Organization. Thanks for watching.